During a meeting held between the Committee of National Economy and officials from the Bank of Uganda, who were appearing to update Parliament on the performance of Uganda's economy and indebtedness, the Deputy Governor of the Bank of Uganda, Michael Ating-Ego, noted that Uganda's economy grew up by 6.8% in June 2023, up from 5.6% in June 2022, a growth he attributed to growth in services and industry output, which grew by 7% and 8.8% respectively.
So this growth has been driven mainly by services and the industry output, which has grown by 7 and 8.8% respectively. So we think that economic growth in the financial year 23-24 is going to be around 6%, and it will increase to anywhere between 6 to 7% in the medium term. And this recovery is largely going to be driven by the services and the industry sectors, and then the investments in the extractive industries, particularly the oil and the gas.
However, a number of MPs cast doubt on these figures, wondering why this growth isn't being felt in the pockets of Ugandans, citing a number of arcades empty downtown and small businesses that are facing similar fates.
If you go to the arcades in town, the shops close regularly. I've taken it upon myself to move downtown many times, and businesses are failing. Small business, which I think contribute greatly to these figures. Governor, if you went to make your presentation, this one here, and you are in Katakwi, you are in Amuria, you are in Soroti, people would ask you what kind of governor is this. Because when you say that the economy is growing or has grown by 6.8%, and then you go and look at our people in the countryside, people are extremely poor. In fact, people are becoming poorer by day, but your economy is improving by day. So how is this translated to now our people?
Honorable Chair, in an economy where the governor is saying the economy has improved and it has grown, but people's assets are gone, I need to know from the governor, for him as a governor, whether when he sits there and sees some of these things, he feels there is some growth.
The deputy governor expressed an urgent need for the government to reduce its borrowing appetite domestically in order to bring down interest rates.
The government borrowing appetite is very huge. Now, if you are borrowing, let's say, through a one-year treasury bill, you are borrowing at, let's say, 14%. But let's say it's not about 12%. One-year treasury bill. Yeah, 12-13%. If I can lend to government at 12-13%, how much are you going to lend a guy in the streets? Why would you bother lending a guy in the street at 9% or a farmer at 10%, no, at 8%, when government can pay you 12%.
A section of committee members put the deputy governor to task to explain what they have done, as regulators have raised complaints from the public regarding fraud in commercial banks. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.